So, are you able to see my PPTs?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Thank you so much, Mr. Jayaraj. And I'm highly grateful to Mr. Abhishek Ranjan and to Red Lantern Analytica for organizing a webinar on such a pertinent topic, which is not only extremely important for India and the world, but also for all of us as citizens of India. I will be, on the contrary, very positive towards this as against our previous speaker. So, before I start with my presentation, let us ponder on to what exactly is happening around the world right now. Let us
Ma'am,
ponder.
if you can, ma'am, if I can request you to put your presentation on a slideshow format so that the
Yes.
size of the content that you've put
Can you
able
see?
to change.
Is it
Yes, ma'am, now
fine?
it's perfect. Perfect.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So, the COVID-19 health pandemic has impacted all the realms of human life. The pandemic has led us to economic crisis throughout the world and made us realize the importance of the Gandhian model of self-reliance. We have seen now self-reliance or self-reliant India here is the growth process of an economy should not become dominated or dependent on another economy. We have seen that we have many times imported the inflation from other countries. Now, that is something we have to go away from. A self-reliant India, a time when the world is suffering from a deadly pandemic, India plans to convert this crisis into an opportunity and strengthen its fight by becoming Atmanirbhar or self-reliant. Now, before I move on further, let us discuss the imports of India vis-a-vis, I would be basically going towards China, but I have the data for all over the world. So if you see here, we in 1989, because of the paucity of time and data, we have converted the PPTs into 10-10 years data structure. So in 1989, we were having maximum of our trade, the imports were coming from United States. Then it was United Kingdom and Japan. In 1999, the structure changed a little. And please see, and please note, China is not here in 1999 as part of our major components coming. So we were imports were coming from Belgium, United States, Saudi Arabia, Nigeria, United Kingdoms. Now, India's imports in 2009, look, we have a jump towards China is with 11.49% coming from China, which was the main component of our imports. Though United States is also there, but it has fallen down to 6.01%. In 2019, China imports became almost 13.7%, which almost touched 15% in the end of 2019. And now let's look at the exports of India. So we've seen the import side. The export side in 1989, our basic exports were with Soviet Union. And in 1999, we started having exports towards United States, which was the dominant. And then second number was China with 6.78%. Whereas in 1999, imports from China were almost negligent. But exports to China were 6.78%. In 2009, if you look, the exports to China is falling down from the previous 10 years' data. It has come down to 5.65. And in 2019, it further fell down to 5.08%. So now, what is important for us to look at is the trade deficit, which was being converted. Now, if you look at the data here, the yellow portion is telling you the imports, and the blue is telling you the exports, and the difference between them, the trade deficit, which is negative, of course, is that of the India, which is there. Now, Somewhere around 2018, the trade deficit increased to $63 billion. But then slowly and gradually, if you look 2019-20, this trade deficit started falling down. Now, that was what we were looking at it from India's point of view. Now, this is from China's point of view. And from China's point of view, if we look here, the maroon shade is the exports and the pink is the import. So if you look that in financial year 15, the export was 2.6 and the import was only 0.8 of China from India. And this increased to only 0.9% in financial year 19, whereas the exports had increased from 2.6 to 3% for China towards India. Now, another important thing that comes into mind is the composition of imports from China. Now, of course, if you look at these figures, the electrical machinery, it in 2017-18, which is green in shade, and the red is the 2018-19, if you see, there is a decrease. But rest of the data, rest of the imports are showing a positive increase. For example, the nuclear machinery, the organic chemicals, they almost increased to 31.5%. Now, what is worrying me is the fertilizers. So if you look at here, there's 108.51% increase in the growth of fertilizer imports from China to India. So that is the composition. So the current scenario, very important and pertinent thoughts that would come into our mind. That is approximately 15% of India's imports and 5% of India's exports are towards China. Will India really be able to break the dependence on China? And would we be successful? This is a very important, pertinent question which would be actually coming in the minds of all of us here. The good news is, if we look at the latest data, the exports to China have actually increased to 6.7% during this pandemic period, and the imports have also decreased from China. So I would say, let us look at the Indian perspective. The Make in India, the initiation or the initiative was started in 2014 by the government of India to encourage companies to manufacture in India and incentivize dedicated investment to manufacturing. We also encouraged the zero effect and zero defect production and maintaining a high quality so that our produce is being readily accepted outside by the world. Government has facilitated investment, innovation, skill development, protected intellectual property, and built best-in-class manufacturing infrastructure in the country. Sell in the world, but manufactured in India was, in fact, is the basic idea. The second is the Atmanirbhar Bharat. The Abhiyan package focuses on land, labor, liquidity, and laws, which will cater to various sections, including cottage, industry, MSMEs, laborers, middle class, and industry. The five pillars that Atmanirbhar is actually catering to is the economy, the infrastructure, system, demography, and demand. So these are very important points. And this Atmanirbhar is a strengthening of the Make in India Abhiyan, which was started in 2014. A boost has been provided with various impetus for the growth of startups in India. In fact, we are seeing a mushrooming up of startups which are being initiated by our youth. The ban on approximately 200 Chinese applications, it is just not a signal, but a lot of substance behind this move of India. We are also limiting the Chinese presence in 5G in India. Many policies have also been devised and implemented towards it. But this is a short-run strategy. If you remember what we just discussed about the imports from China and its dependence and our dependence on those imports, we need a very long-run strategy. We need to go away from the structural import dependency on China. It will take approximately 2 to 8 years for India to make domestic base for the same. In fact, we are trying to reduce these dependencies, and that is predominantly why Make in India was launched. Indian government is now trying to come out with policies to attract global value chains and supply chains in India. A move has started, and we are seeing that a lot of FDIs are flowing down to India. 18th largest FDI in India is from China. But the good thing is that 90% of the direct investment from China is in manufacturing. And this should continue as India is having favorable policies for the same. Now let us look at the world perspective. Now that was the Indian perspective. Now there's a world perspective which is also helping India to grow further. At present, economic blowback is being faced by China from throughout the world. The world has realized the risks associated for being heavily reliant on one country, that is China, for global supply chain. Because of the population structure in China, there is a rising wage cost, and multinationals have been thinking since a number of years how they can diversify and move away from China dominance and find a production base outside China, which will have low costs, good supply chains, and markets. And please remember here that India has the second largest population in the world. And look at the amount of demand we can create in our own country. China, as of now, is facing trouble with its relations with most of its top trading partners like South Korea, Japan, US, Australia, India, etc. It is also facing problems because of its wolf warrior diplomacy. Now, this brings me back to our last slide. India will emerge as a production destination hub, and we will be able to go away from China, maybe not now, but yes, over a period of time, because all our policies and our initiatives are going in the right direction. Of course, we require a lot of technology, and we do require a lot of investment in technology, and that also is going ahead. Emotional and the India is in its favor, in fact, highly in favor of India. We have already started off with the skill-oriented education system, and we are following it rigorously, especially with the new education policy. The English speaking population of India is dominant in India, which helps the value chains to be created now back into India rather than China. And the democratic country which we are will help us to have the MNCs coming back into India from China and we moving away from China towards India. We therefore propose that our economy will rise steeply as soon as we overcome with this pandemic. Thank you.